Deputy Keevan O'Fallon.
I'm calling you. Taoiseach, on Monday, the Minister for Health wrote to the Oireachtas Committee on Health and Children to advise that he would not now be attending at tomorrow's scheduled meeting of the committee to discuss the HSE National Service Plan for 2014, because, as he says, it's still not ready. And Taoiseach, there is now the real possibility, uniquely perhaps, that we will not have an opportunity to discuss the HSE Service Plan for 2014 in advance of the new year and its introduction. Now, that is a bizarre situation. And signing off and indeed the publication of the plan have already been delayed on a number of occasions, the Minister granting extensions to the HSE. And, you know, I have to say that that is not surprising, because in your budget 2014, you were imposing cuts of at least 666 million in terms of the health budget for the coming year. And Taoiseach, you know in your heart and soul that that is simply unsustainable. You have given your health ministers, I believe, the health department and the HSE, an impossible task. And more importantly, you are imposing on frontline workers within the health services an impossible burden, and also on patients. Now, can the Taoiseach tell us, can you tell us how it will be possible to maintain health services in 2014 on such a drastically reduced budget? And this, when only yesterday, Taoiseach, we have the publication of a supplementary estimate that is to come before us for a further 219 million for the health services in order for the health service executive to be able to get to the end of this month. It's time to face the facts.
Thank you.
And I have it to say, Taoiseach, that there is grave, grave concern. Can I ask you, Taoiseach, in conclusion at this point? It is reported that the Director General of the HSE, Tony O'Brien, has written to the government to state that the figure for medical card cuts in the draft service plan is in fact 133 million and not the 113 million as was signalled in the budget statement, and that the medical card cuts in fact against the advice of the HSE and indeed against the advice of the Department of Health. Can you confirm that letter and indeed the figures that it cites?
Taoiseach.
But what I can confirm to you is that the process that's followed here, Deputy O'Quillan, is one that's well known to yourself. You were at the meeting yesterday. You were aware of the Minister's intention to attend at the committee once a due process has been followed in respect of provision of the HRC service plan. Now, the budget takes place in October. There's a vote given for the health estimate for 2014. Following that, the Health Service Executive have a requirement to produce their draft plan as to how they intend to run the services for 2014 based on that figure. That draft plan is sent to the Minister for Health for his approval or for his amendment and acceptance of the report. The Minister has until Monday, I think it's the 16th, in order to respond to the Health Service Executive following his having received the draft programme. So that's the system that operates. So Minister is currently going through the draft plan as submitted by the Health Service Executive. He's already made clear that for this year he requires a supplementary estimate of 199 million. This is not the first time this has happened in the Department of Health. Clearly he indicated this last September, October, that it would be somewhere less than 200 million that would be required in respect of 2013. So it's a matter for the committee, Deputy O'Quillan, as to when they want the minister to attend. So I expect that the minister will comply. Oh well, you're somebody to talk about health, aren't you?
Thanks very much.
I think there were a few, major runs, overruns in your time, So the answer to your question is, Deputy O'Callaghan, I expect the Minister will comply with his requirement, Deputy, to respond to the Health Service Executive with his views on the draft plan as submitted and his recommendation for acceptance or otherwise. And we'll be quite happy, obviously, in public forum to discuss this matter with the committee. And I'm sure, as he indicated at yesterday's meeting, he's more than happy to attend. So process is now nearing a conclusion because there's a timeline on it. And I expect that next week you'll see the evidence of the and the conclusion of the deliberations of the minister. But there's no intention here of trying to, you know, delay the opportunity for the committee, of which you remember, to discuss these things and give out, as you normally will, about things that, in the system. His priority is to focus on the delivery of effective services in the front line. And clearly there are challenges, obviously, for all ministers and for all departments in government in meeting these objectives and targets. So Minister Riley's no different from that point of view.
Deputy O'Callaghan, 1 minute.
Taoiseach, one would almost draw from your remarks that it was the committee's fault that the minister hasn't yet come forward with the National Service Plan for 2014. Let me assure you, Taoiseach and Deputy Buttermer, that the committee are quite prepared to engage with the minister in relation to the National Service Plan. So let's be clear. The minister gave an extension of 10 days to the HSE in order to publish the service plan. Then he gave a further 10 days to the HSE to complete their deliberations. I have asked you very important questions. I have asked you, are you aware of a letter from the Director General of the HSE in relation to the service plan, quite particularly addressing the issue of the cuts to medical card provision in the coming year? And that, in fact, the figure presented in the budget statement back in October is an understatement of what is actually to be provided for by 20 million. That it's 133 million.
Question, please. Thank you.
I am asking the Taoiseach, is he aware of this letter? Is he aware that it is indicated strongly, clearly, that the HSE and the Department of Health are opposed to the extent of cuts that are being sought in terms of medical card provision, and that they also make the case that 666 million, which might not actually be the total sum involved, is impossible to extract from a health budget that has been decimated year on year over this past number of years? Minister or Taoiseach, in conclusion, can you give us any idea of the numbers of people who are now likely to lose their medical cards at the end of this year and in the coming year because of decisions to to arrest the sum being provided in order to give them the certainty and the comfort and the assurance of a medical card, be they people in advanced years?
Deputy, would you please?
In many cases, in families across the country, children dealing with very sick issues.
I'd ask people to try and stick to the allocated time, otherwise change the time allocated. But don't have me interrupting everybody, day in, day out. Please, there's a minute to reply. Thank you, Taoiseach.
Well, I don't want to get into the details of any aspect of the many areas that are involved in the health budget. I know that the Health Service Executive did write to the Minister with their submission of the draft plan for service provision for 2014, and I know that a number of matters that were referred to in the letter are being considered by government as how best to deal with them. I'm not actually aware, genuinely, of the specific point that you mentioned, but what I want to repeat to you is that the Minister for Health has a responsibility to assess the draft plan as submitted by the Health Service Executive to provide services for 2014 and to respond to the Health Service Executive with his approval or amendments to the draft plan as he considers. And that work is now concluding with the Minister for Health. So next week I think we'll see the We'll see the result of his deliberations here.
Thank you.
The minister's focus is on the provision of the excellent frontline services that are being provided. And I don't agree with your sort of scaremongering tactics here. We have an unprecedented number of medical cards issued and being issued, with the highest ever numbers in the country covered by the medical card service. I agree with you. There were quite a number of sensitive cases that came to light following the centralisation of the medical card system. We called those before the Cabinet Subcommittee. A process was put in place to deal with cases, particularly where discussion was required. And we've had numbers raised over the last number of weeks that I think have brought a requirement for an experience to deal with particular kinds of cases, and I think that's been put in place. So next week, Deputy O'Quillan, we'll see the Minister respond to the Health Service Executive and their draft plan and deal with all of these issues in the best way that we can, while maintaining frontline services to give the most effective and the highest standard of medical care to our people.
Deputy Healy.
Yes, I don't see.
Deputy Healy. Well,
you were
I'm
at the meeting.
I'm not asking you, Deputy Bottomer. I'm asking you.
You were at the meeting.
Deputy Healy.
You were at the meeting yesterday. The meeting was. You were at the meeting yesterday. The meeting was a tentative
Sorry,
meeting.
Sorry, Taoiseach. The time is up. Please, Deputy Healy. I called him already. Deputy Bottomer, would you please stay quiet or leave the chamber? Thank you.